Hello world, from whichever time zone you're catching me from, my name is MD90. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on the bell notification to all so that you do not miss the uploads that come out. And the easiest way for you to navigate the channel is to head to the playlist. You'll find videos curated for you based on your interest. So if you're interested in the Kutika podcast, you'll find a playlist for that. For news and trends, there's a playlist for that. Exclusive with MD90, a bunch of playlists that are created based on your interest. So the easiest way to navigate the channel is head straight to the playlist and you'll find what you're here for. Consider becoming a member of the channel. Right next to the subscribe button is the join button. You click on the join button so that you can become a member of the channel. You support the team on the production and the number of things that we're doing here, and we appreciate that. So these are images from a couple of minutes ago. So President Edgar Chagwalungu accompanied his wife, Mrs. Lungu, at Magistrate Court. So this is what it says. So 60th President Dr. Edgar Chagwalungu and his dear wife, Miss Esther Lungu, have arrived at Magistrate Court complex in Lusaka, where the former First Lady is appearing before Magistrate Mbuyana Simvula. This is in a matter where she's been charged with theft of property. If you remember, should have been last year when police broke into the residence that the government was paying for Edgar Chagwalungu, the former footballer. In fact, he still plays football. Stopila Nsunzu's house, and then recovered a couple of cars that were alleged to be stolen property. So they are in court over this issue, and this is what the president accompanied his wife for. So he's been in court every time that she makes a court appearance. So that's what happened a couple of minutes ago. But in other news, the issue of Cornelius Mweetwa making a statement with regard to the regulation of online broadcasts, Raul Amiti has made a statement. So Ms. Miti has told off Mr. Mweetwa to go and find something useful to do, like freeing ZNBC from the political shackles it remains under. So Ms. Miti said it is uncalled for the government and ill-treat citizens by introducing a law that will disadvantage them from enjoying their freedom of expression. She said citizens depended on online as a source of information regulating podcasts through the law is unfair and unreasonable. Ms. Miti said Mr. Mweetwa should immediately stop the undemocratic maneuver against citizens, our freedom of expression, whose only source of information was online platforms. So this conversation has been going on for a while now, since the minister issued that statement to say the IBA is working on a law and regulation to make sure that online platforms that are running podcasts he mentioned, and obviously other platforms, are supposed to be regulated. So people are that's not sitting well with people. So this is where the conversation is coming from. Anyway, we wait and see how it plays out. But in other news, Simon Mwaleden has been going back and forth with CR1. So to start with, CR1 was the first person that instigated this conversation. In this video that was posted by Mark2, you could see CR1 making an insinuation to say some people just use English, they have nothing to account for. And he was giving credit to people like Sparks Mining to say, according to him, and if you can read from what Mark2 also captioned there, to say a lot of Sparks, meaning like Sparks is not able to speak English, according to CR1, and that caption that Mark2 laughs off to say, you're not able to speak English, but you've got the money and resources. So CR1 was mocking Mr. Chitambala, who is commonly known as Simon Mwaleden, that runs that platform, to say he's got good English, but he has nothing to show for, and only depends on the inheritance from his dad. So that's the video there to say, and he also undermines his own people in that particular video that was posted. And obviously, you expected in the comment section, people could read where that particular video was directed. So he says, I'm not a prophet. This was Henry Muleya. I'm responding to say, I'm not a prophet, but I know he's talking about Uncle 100 KG Bokos. So if you remember at some point, Simon Mweetwa and Chief Fetayari had a back and forth where Chief Fetayari was allegedly said that he had a 100 KG backside. Meaning Mr. Mweetwa. So that's where that caption comes from, to say CR1 was referring to Mr. Mweetwa in this regard. And obviously you don't expect Mr. Mweetwa to miss out on such online back and forth. So definitely he was in Mongo where this image was captured. So once he got back in town, he responded to CR1 immediately a couple of hours ago. So he says, you Andrew, he demands you, okay, and then he captions it, CS0. It's very foolish. First, he says Akainde Ichitema will be forcefully removed from office by 2025. Now, today, he says Akainde Ichitema cannot lose in 2026. At least, my false prophets are useless. They do not know what they want. He will just concentrate on your country, Nigeria. So, he's right here, Mr. Mweetwa is right here to say, CR1 has been all over the place with this. So what CR1 does is that he reads the Zambian online conversations, and obviously he's got these people that still follow him in Zambia. So when he sees that the temperature online, like people are anti-government, making pretty much grievances, he goes live and says, no, Hakainde Ichitema will not make it into 2026. But when he sees everything is going in favor with the current president, Hakainde Ichitema, then he switches up. So this is what Mr. Mweetwa is responding to say. I mean, he's all over the place. Once he sees that no things are favoring the incumbent president, Hakainde Ichitema, then he switches up to say, no one is able to beat Hakainde Ichitema in 2026. And then when he sees the public sentiments go opposite against the president, then he switches up. So he's saying, you're all over the place. Focus on your own country. Obviously, he did not stop there. He went further. He says, you can force prophet Andrew Ijimandu. And then he captions it again, aka CS0. They have kidnapped 200 plus pupils in Nigeria. Why aren't you talking about your own your country? But Kamuntu, pirikiti, talking about Zambia. Andrew, you are a very silly boy. So there is a situation in Nigeria where over 200 pupils have been kidnapped. And it's true. He has not made any comment. But one thing you should understand about CR1 is like, he's some sort of, he's a content creator. So his demographic, in as much as he's trying to get that Nigerian audience now, but most of his audience is Zambian because he spent a couple of years in Zambia. So that platform that he runs, his Facebook page and any other thing that he runs online, is very much dependent on Zambia's audience. So when he starts putting out content that Zambians are not interested in, obviously the algorithm kills the spread of his posts. So you see the traffic reduces on that. So definitely that's why you see him every now and then does like a live stream about Zambian politics and something to do with Zambia, because he knows that's what's going to draw the Zambian audience to his page and stuff. So that's why you see him not commenting about the Nigerian situation, because if he had that Nigerian audience, he would do it, definitely. So he's simply being cautious about his platform, trying to safeguard it. So that's why he hasn't been going live with that. But this kind of Sondo Mwenda has been tagging President Hakainde Ichitema. Instead, Mr. Mweetwa actually is saying Hakainde Ichitema lied over maize and disaster declaration. Do these two leaders talk to each other? This he asks. So there have been different statements coming from government saying maize was not sold. Other statements, I mean, maize was sold, and that's why there's a deficit. Same situation with regard to the disaster declaration to say Zambia is not in need of help. And then, so Kasondo Mwenda asked to say, have they been communicating, because those statements are conflicting. This is the EFF leader or president. And these are some of the highlights from the court. So people have been saying to say, Mumbipili, the lady in blue with Esther Lungu here, say she seems very close to the former president, Edgar Chagwa Lungu, because Even during the greeting, if you see the videos when he was greeting everybody here, you could see like how happy he was to see her and stuff like that. I could see why he made a secretary general during his tenure of office. They seemed to have a good relationship with him, his wife, and Mumbipiri. So she was at court when Eselungu was appearing before court, and this is where those images are taken from. Other highlights are from yesterday. The president seems to have used a different car when he was in Eastern Province. So he was in that BMW, and that's his entourage. You can see from there. And then another highlight is this situation in Chipata. If you've never been to Chipata, it's dominated by bicycle riders. It's very mountainous. So for a while, they've got a new unique culture. So if you want to move around the city, you can't say it's because of traffic. There's never really a traffic jam in Chipata Eastern Province, but for some reason, it's very dominated by these bicycles. Maybe at some point, they never used to have a lot of cars, but yeah. So that culture has persisted even now. So if you want to move around the city, it's a different experience. As you can see, this was during the youth celebration. So they were part of the highlights as they came. But they've been evolving over time. Now they're moving on to motorbikes. So the bicycle riders, obviously, after a while, once they run the business, you make a profit, they invest in buying a motorbike. So that's the only place that you would find. Lusaka is not very dominated by bikes. Now, because of these couriers that are food delivery systems, motorbikes are also coming in into Lusaka to beat traffic in Lusaka. But in Eastern Province, it's just a culture. People prefer bicycles, now moving on to motorbikes. So these are some of the highlights from the youth celebration. And obviously, the cadets made a highlight during the same celebration. They had the opportunity, obviously, to mingle with the president. These kids are going to preserve these pictures, standing right next to the head of state, sitting president, Hakainde Hichilema. And obviously, the far left here, you see a girl and a guy on the right there. So these are images from yesterday. Anyway, that's the news, ladies and gentlemen.
My YouTube channel. Make sure you click on the subscribe button, you click on the notifications to get the notifications of every video that I upload. I try to upload every week, sometimes every day of the week, but definitely each week you expect a video. So make sure you click on the subscribe, like this video, and there's much more on the playlist. So visit the channel and see you around.